A little while ago, I made a video about salt in which I told you that there were no substitutes for salt. No sodium chloride, no salty taste. Well, I was totally wrong. One of my favorite things about this channel is that through it, I get to meet people who know a lot about science, way more than I do. So one of those wonderful people, Harry Lee, told me about potassium chloride. It's also a salt, just like sodium chloride. Apparently, from the chemistry perspective, there are a whole bunch of salts out there. Of course, some of them just happen to be poisonous, like lithium chloride, but potassium chloride is not only totally safe, it's actually good for you because potassium lowers blood pressure. Why have I never heard of it? I grabbed my copy of Harold McGee's On Food and Cooking. No mention. Kenji Alt's The Food Lab? No mention. Samin Nasrat's Salt, Fat, Acid, Heat? No mention. After Googling, I finally found it mentioned on SeriousEats.com, but only once and only in passing, and it was described as salty but bitter. It was actually Cook's Illustrated that turned out to be the best source of information on cooking with potassium chloride. They said that it's actually not bad, as long as you combine it with at least a little bit of sodium chloride. Their favorite product was the same one Harry mentioned. It's called Low Salt, and it combines one part sodium chloride and two parts potassium chloride. Is potassium chloride actually salty? I was so curious, I had to try it, so I went ahead and bought some low salt. I've actually seen this product in the stores before, but I was always very skeptical about it. I thought that the only part of it that would actually be salty was the sodium chloride. And I thought it was kind of like a silly psychological trick where you'd give the salt shaker as many shakes as you usually would, but end up with only a third of salinity. So although they made it look very low sodium, you would actually need much more of it than normal salt to make it just as salty. Well, so the first test I did was to make salt water. I made a solution of 100 grams water and 1 gram of low salt. For comparison, I made a solution of 100 grams water and 1 gram of diamond crystal kosher salt. They tasted identical. I'm not kidding. I tried the same test with unsalted chicken stock, where I seasoned it with low salt and diamond crystal kosher salt, weighing everything, making sure it was the same exact amount of everything, and no difference. Potassium chloride seems to be just as salty as sodium chloride. Does it work in brines? Cook's Illustrated said it does, because it is the chloride ions that bind to the proteins and help them retain their moisture. And both potassium chloride and sodium chloride have those wonderful chloride ions. They said that they brined some proteins with low salt and regular salt and couldn't tell the difference. So I decided to give this a go. I do not wet brine, I only dry brine, so I tried that. Dry brining is just sprinkling salt on the surface of the protein and letting it absorb for several hours. I tried that with swordfish. I took two swordfish steaks, I sprinkled some low salt on one and some diamond crystal kosher salt on another, and I let it absorb for about 2 hours, and then I cooked them and fed them to my unsuspecting family. They never know when I'm doing an experiment on them. You know what? Any dinner in this house could be an experiment. Nobody noticed the difference. I knew which one was which steak was which, and even I couldn't tell. Is potassium chloride bitter? It's usually described as bitter, but is it? I personally did not notice any bitterness or any other weird aftertastes until I started using it on vegetables. I tried low salt in a farro mushroom risotto and on roasted broccoli. I can't say that it tasted bitter to me. I would describe this sensation as slightly metallic. Of course, I was biased, so I decided to feed these dishes to my family and see if they notice anything being off. With mushroom risotto, nobody noticed. When I asked, was there anything unusual about it? They looked at me like I had two heads. Everything seemed to be totally fine. But with broccoli, they did. They couldn't really put their finger on what was wrong with this broccoli, but it just wasn't as good as it is usually. It was interesting to me that I didn't notice this weird aftertaste in water, stock, or with swordfish, but I did notice it with mushrooms and broccoli. So, here is my bitterness hypothesis. First, a little background on bitterness. This idea that we have different receptors in our tongue for different tastes, like there are receptors for bitterness and receptors for saltiness and receptors for sweetness, is actually outdated. Most recent research shows that the same cell in our tongue can respond to many different tastes, like salt, sweet, bitter, etc. That's why one taste can inhibit another. And there is a lot of agreement among scientists that salt inhibits bitterness and amplifies sweetness. So this explains why broccoli made with potassium chloride might not be quite as tasty as broccoli made with sodium chloride. It's possible that sodium blocks bitterness better than potassium. You know, in things like chicken stock and swordfish, there was no bitterness to block. But in vegetables, there is definitely some bitterness, especially green vegetables like broccoli. Yeah, they're naturally slightly bitter. So that's probably why they can benefit from sodium chloride. I am used to salt making food not just more salty, but also more tasty. And I felt that broccoli made with potassium chloride was maybe a little bit less tasty than I am used to. But that being said, if I had to choose between bland broccoli with a third of salt of any kind versus low salt broccoli, by low salt I mean like broccoli made with the low salt product, I would choose the low salt broccoli. You know, I think that's better than blandness. Some things to keep in mind. People vary a lot in their perception of bitterness. About 25% of population are super tasters. In other words, they are very, very sensitive to bitterness. I am not a super taster. I am very comfortable with bitterness. So your experience with potassium chloride might be very different from mine. It is possible that potassium chloride in itself is a little bitter, and I simply couldn't tell. If you want to play around with salt substitutes, I would definitely suggest a product that combines potassium chloride with at least some sodium chloride. That will help with bitterness. Also, start with starches and meats and see how you like it. If it goes well for you, well, then try it on vegetables. There are a few health considerations to keep in mind. If you want to try a salt substitute in your diet, ask your doctor about it. Potassium chloride does seem to be really good for people with high blood pressure because it lowers blood pressure, but it might not be good for people with certain types of kidney disease because your kidneys might not be able to handle extra potassium. So don't listen to me, talk to your doctor. I'm not a doctor. Oh, and keep in mind that if your only source of sodium is a salt substitute, even one containing a small quantity of sodium chloride, you might end up sodium deficient. I know that popular media loves to demonize sodium, but believe it or not, we need some sodium in order for our bodies to function. So make sure you get enough. Harry, thank you. This has been by far the most interesting thing I've learned about cooking this year. If you enjoy videos about cooking techniques and thought-provoking culinary topics like this one, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you are ever in the Boston area, maybe I'll see you in one of my classes.